Great question. If you look at the industry evolutions, I have been in this industry for 30 years. You can break all the evolutions into four dimensions. The first evolution that happened is on the infrastructure side, where individual people used to have their own PCs, and they wanted to share those individual PCs. That's when the test lab was created. So if you really see, that dimension was really initiated by test engineers. They did the consolidation of all the machines, and that was called a test lab. Then over a period of time, they added some compliance requirements to it. It became data center. When they added to the data center, they wanted to have more operating systems than what they have. So they created virtualization. So the testing people also said, okay, let's have a quick control of all these resources, whether it is virtual or whether it is real. And that became data center. Then looking at the reliability of the test lab data center, the companies decided, okay, let's host our services on those data centers so that our customers can use it, using the very own processes which were created by the test engineers. That became the industrialized data center, and then cloud evolved from it. The cloud is nothing but, you know, something which is elastic. You put a small data center somewhere, and then you keep elongating it based on the needs, based on utilization. Elasticity does not mean only expanding, but also whenever there is no load, bring it down. That is what is cloud. And after cloud, now people are actually talking about, you know, having virtual images within virtual images, which are called your Dockers, containers, and Kubernetes. That's one side of the dimension. That is dimension one, which was initiated by the test engineers. Let me talk about the second dimension, which obviously was not created by the testing teams, but it evolved over a period of time. Those days we used to have desktops, then it became laptops, smaller in size, then it became pantops, even smaller in size, then it became mobile, and today we are actually talking about IoT devices, which go and sit in each and every appliances at home. That is the second dimension of the evolution. If you look at the third evolution of dimension, you know, the process delivery model. You had waterfall model, where a strict coding is completed, and only then testing was done. And after that, you know, people wanted to parallelize testing and development. Then they evolved V model, and V model became spiral model. Then spiral model became agile model. Then the agile model is becoming super lean model, which is called a lean development, Toyota-based processes and things like that. That is on the process delivery model. That's the third dimension to it. The fourth dimension to the evolutions, what I have seen in the last 30 years, is the customer payment model. Initially, you know, when all the desktops and the other things were available in the office, you know, they were all purchased by paying full cash, which is 100% capex and 0% opex. The electricity was paid by the same company. The maintenance was paid by the same company. There was no operational expenditure. Everything is a capital expenditure. And slowly they moved into optimal capex and opex. You know, they wanted to outsource some of the maintenance part of those machines. Wherein you know, they brought in some element of operational expenses other than capital expenditure. Then they went into another model where there is less capex but more opex. They started renting out the machines from outside, and after that, you know, consumption based volumetric model evolved, where, you know, you buy the product from us, depending on the number of users you have, or depending upon the number of amount of utilization those users had, we will charge you. That became the consumption based volumetric model. And the last one, you know, which is becoming predominant now, is pay-per use. You know, you don't invest anything, zero capex, and everything is opex. So it is like, you know, going in Uber or Ola. You know, the insurance is paid, the car is bought by the company, and you just go use it, and for the amount of time and amount of the distance you have used, you pay them. So whenever you want, you can do it. You can rent out a Mercedes today, you know, use it as it is your own vehicle, but you still need not invest on it. So these are the four different dimensions, you know, the industry has evolved, in my opinion. Actually, if you see, the intersection of all these four is the sweet spot all the test engineers should work on. If you see the, you know, the dimension one and the four, the infrastructure as well as the process delivery model, both of them are invented by the QA engineers. Moving to the waterfall model to V model is actually done by a QA engineer. The moving from the individually kept machines to a lab, a test lab, was actually initiated by the testing teams. So majority of the evolution, what you see in the industry, the starting point is testing. And the sweet spot for the test engineers is to look at all these four dimensions and how they are going. What I told you is only the 30-year story. It will continue for another 30 years or another 60 years. You know, but these dimensions will stay, but the evolutions will continue to happen. So actually the sweet spot here is intersection of all the four, which tells you how fast we should evolve. So speed is very, very important. And second thing, no investment. You know, if you know everything is becoming virtual, the companies will become virtual, the offices will become virtual. People can work from home and people can take jobs, workloads, which you call it as workloads, from the internet. And you may not have any manager. You may not have any infrastructure. Your capital expenditure may be zero sitting at home and you'll be still delivering the products. And most of it, what you do sitting at home would be untesting. So that's where I think the industry is evolving into.
Delighted to understand that, you know, you put a very different twist that, you know, testers had a very significant role in some of these dimensions. I've never heard that. That's very interesting to me.
You know, it is always the testers who give challenges to the developers and then you kick them in behind, you know, from behind so that they can move forward. So not only these two dimensions, in my opinion, all the four dimensions are invented by testers. Because if you really look at the physical access medium, you know, those were the testers, you know, who were carrying the machines, who said it is heavy for me to carry, you know, give me something which is light. That's where the laptop came. So if you go into the history, you will always see, you know, every development had the role of both testers and developers. Not only the testers, but both testers and the developers. But the testers are the people who want to invent fast because they are the people who are going through the pain of developing the products and testing the product which are not even ready.